need to jump out if you get too hot in there. There's a problem with the cooling system and it's going to take us a few minutes to correct it. There'll be a lack of rubber out on track, so take it easy for the first couple of laps. expect to see some rain about 10 to 15 minutes from now. job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that. Well done. Understood. Stopping this lap. Garage, please. Cars ready to leave. practice program over. That's all we need for now, so return to the garage as soon as you can. Okay, we can take you this lap. Session there, then let's remind ourselves of the top three, which are Adams, Hauger, and Lynn Lawson. Practice times are on the board then, but no points are on offer just yet. We'll be back with more F2 action soon. set for the race tomorrow. But before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, which are Adams, Owasa, and Richard for sure. The grid is set then, so that just leaves the race itself. Join us tomorrow where we'll be live with all the action. Until then, goodbye. Welcome to one of, if not the most iconic race circuit in Formula 2. A track with absolutely no room for error, a track that requires every bit of skill these young drivers can muster. We're getting ready for lights out here in Monte Carlo. The Circuit de Monaco is, for all practical purposes, pretty much unchanged since its 1929 introduction. It's strange to consider, but this 2.1-mile lap will take the drivers here around almost an entire country. 19 corners, but not that many opportunities for overtaking. Instead, this is a track that rewards technical skill. We are nearly ready for the start of today's race, but in the meantime, let's take a look at the grid. Adams lines up on pole position, and it's Ayumu Owasa in P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vachon, Porcher, Marino Sato, Novalak, Deruvola, Calderon, Cordiel, Oli Caldwell, Hauger, Phipps, Felipe Dragovic, Liam Lawson, Williams, Sargeant, Doohan, Jake Hughes, Vesti, Fittipaldi, Nissani, and Ralph Boschoff completes the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track. I'm not the only one sitting here today who's looking forward to today's race. My friend and GP2 champion Davide Valsecchi is next to me, already on the edge of his seat, awaiting the start of the event. How's it going today?
Hello there, Alex. I'm great, thank you. And very excited to get started. I have a feeling we are in for a very special event today.
Okay, we've got that relief of having points on the board finally, so let's keep that form up and get another top 10 finish today, please. Clutch bright is good, gearbox is responding normally. Make sure to warm up the tyres and brakes. Warm the tyres and brakes throughout the lap, please. Make sure we get a great launch as the race starts. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with the clutch. approaching the pit window and we're going to put you onto super softs. Receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross onto the track. job. Nice overtake. teammate by 30.1 seconds. Superb driving. That is the race win, my friend. Well done.
Brilliant stuff from Hi-Tech GP today. What a superb victory. And I have to wonder, Davide Valsecchi, just what set them apart from the competition here?
The difference was in the strategy. Credit to the driver for sure, but races like these really drive home how much of a team sport this is. They did a lot of work on the pit wall to really make the most of each stint and to make the best use of the tires. But that said, all of that would have been for nothing without a talented hand on the wheel.
And as they make their way down to the podium, there's no denying the strength of the Hi-Tech GP team. It was an incredible performance today, and they fully deserve to stand on the top step. Take a look at the driver's stand. Adams increases their championship lead. And now, Davide Valsecchi, let me ask you, who is your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Adams. Look at where they finished compared to where they started. It's not easy to cut through the field like that in Formula 2, so it was a great effort.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Teams Championship. Hi-Tech GP moved to the top of the table. Meanwhile, a strong weekend from ART this time out, and they improved their position in the championship. After all this drama, you would be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.
Okay, let's see if we can get the car up into P9. P9 by the end of the race, please. Racing like that, mate. Come on, you need to keep it together. I'm afraid you've been given a time penalty for that last incident, mate. Yeah, I'll take that. You smashed that target. Well done.
They take the checkered flag then here in Canada in what has been another fabulous Grand Prix. So, Natalie, what do you think helped them deliver this result?
Back in 2022, the new regulations came in with a promise of more wheel-to-wheel racing. That's exactly what we got today, and that has been the trend ever since their inception. Long may it continue.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race. welcome along, ladies and gentlemen, to our latest F1 World event. So many stories up and down the grid, but there can only be one winner. With top speeds reaching 215 miles per hour, only a few places can challenge Monza's crown as the fastest track in Formula One. Hard braking zones going into the three chicanes make up the majority of the 11 corners on this 3.6 mile circuit. And just in case the slipstream wasn't enough, two DRS zones will help encourage some close action. So, Anthony Day.
A nasty hit. Turn the engine off and wait for the marshals. Well, it's a new format for me. It might. DRS now available.
Goals are optional challenges that you can complete for extra rewards. When you've completed one, be sure to come back and... Great job! Completing all those goals has earned your team valuable experience, and now you can start to explore vendor goals. So now you can go and select vendor goals and check them out. These team members have more goals for you to take on. Each has their own area of specialisation and offers goals relating to that speciality. Okay, so let's explore them now. Taking on a vendor goal requires investment, in other words, cash, but the rewards are always worth it. Be aware that you can only have a certain number of vendor goals active at any time, so pick the areas that you want to pursue carefully and look for... As you play F1 World, you're going to get what we call resources, and they can be used later on to engineer brand new items for your car. Okay, in this category, these are the different blueprints that you can engineer. This is the item the blueprint will create, and these are the resources required to engineer the item.
Get it done.
right, race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
It was a magnificent race and a drive right out of the top draw to take the win for Red Bull today. Red Bull put up a... Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver?
Compendium's basically a celebration of all things F1. You earn stickers as you play F1 World, and then when you've got them, you place them in the Compendium, and that completes entries, and from there you earn those all-important rewards. Okay, so any new stickers you acquire are going to turn up here, and then you can open them. So, let's go and have a look, see what you got. Just opened a sticker. Now you need to go and stick it in. Find an entry for which you have a new sticker. You can use the filter button below to make that easier if you need to. Then select the entry to go and place it. Some entries will require more than one sticker. Completing entries is a great way to earn rewards that'll help you on your way through F1 World. So check back here whenever you earn new stickers.
Don't push the car just yet. Track is still green. Try to take it easy for the first couple of laps. and a job well done. We got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can take you through the numbers. Right, let's have you in at the end of this lap, please. Okay, engines fired up, we're set. then come into the pits at the end of this lap.
are now over the line.
Job, mate. Really, really well done. That was a fantastic drive. Bring it home.
As we wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. Adams, Drugovich, Amery. Welcome back to Baku. We're on the edge of the Caspian Sea in a bustling, vibrant capital, which once again plays host to the spectacle of Formula 2. Let's look at the grid order for today's race while the cars make their final preparations. Adams lines up on pole position, and it's Felipe Drugovich in P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Cordiel, for sure. Callum Williams and Deruvola. Awasa, Fittipaldi, Hauger, Teo Pourchaire, Phipps, Doohan, Frederick Vesti, Fermon Novella, and Sato, Lawson, Calderon, Jake Hughes, Caldwell, Sargent, Nissani, and Ralph Boschon completes the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. As we await the start of another hugely anticipated Formula 2 race, I'm joined again by Davide Valsecchi. Davide, as a former GP2 champion, can we get some insight to what is running through these young drivers' heads as they sit out on the grid?
Ciao, Alex. It's a pleasure to be here. They are nervy moments. There is no doubts about that. Mental strength is the key to remaining calm and focusing on the upcoming race. Formula 2 is so competitive, and all of these drivers know that they are going to be pushing each other all of the way. In these sports, you have to be able to control your nerves.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going. Okay, so let's go through all the gears if you can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool though, so don't go too high with the revs. Radar is clear, weather is looking good for now. Let's try and get a good launch as... behind is 18.8 seconds.
Looks like the pit crew are out and ready to perform their magic on the car. They will be aiming to achieve the fastest pit time possible. A decent pit time then. The team will be hoping they can get back into the action as fast as possible and not lose too much time from this stop.
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. superb driving. That is the race win, my friend. Well done.
It was touch and go for a while there, but High Tech GP have done it. A great win. Tell me, Davide, what was the key to this success?
It was down to one thing. Consistent pace over everyone else out there on the track. We could spend a great deal of time talking about race and tire strategy, what is so cool on the track. But at the end of the day, the difference here was down to simply being faster on track than everyone else. Amazing skill on show.
And it's time now for the podium celebrations. And how well deserved is this one? What a fantastic victory for High Tech GP. Affects the drivers' championship. Adams increases their championship lead. And so, driver of the day then, Davide Valsecchi, who do you think you'd go for?
Let's give it to Felipe Drugovic. That was a quality drive from start to finish. He can be proud of that one.
And now a look at the team standings. High Tech GP moved to the top of the table. It was also a strong race from Trident this weekend. Fantastic work from the Italian team to move themselves further up the table. There will be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you'll join us at the next race when Formula 2 returns.